Once the leaves are dipped in boiling water, the next step will be dip the leaves, which are now softer, dip them in alcohol, and then heat until the alcohol boils. So you can check out the diagram here. Remember, alcohol is highly inflammable, so you should not place it directly upon the fire. So you must always maintain a water bath condition. Water bath condition means take a vessel in which take a vessel with some water. The vessel can be a beaker or any normal vessel, a metallic vessel also can be taken. Then in that vessel, place another beaker containing alcohol. It can be a beaker or it can be a test tube. I have already sent the videos and pictures related to this, so you can check out those. In the activity which we have done in the lab, I have used test tube in the place of beaker, and I have used some other vessel for boiling. Yes, I use beaker in the place of vessel. So you may take any desirable vessel or container, but this condition has to be maintained. This is called water bath condition. So in the water bath, we have placed a beaker which is containing alcohol, and the leaves are placed in the alcohol. Remember, chlorophyll cannot be dissolved in water very easily. It is perennially soluble, but it is very easily soluble in an organic solvent like alcohol. So after a while, when the alcohol starts boiling, you'll be able to find that the chlorophyll is getting dissolved in alcohol, and alcohol has turned greenish. The leaves will turn pale. Check out the pictures for those. The pale leaves are now rings in water. Remember, once the leaves are dipped in alcohol, it becomes very, very fragile. They break very easily. So what to do is wash them very gently. Just dip them in water, wash them very gently, keep it ready, aside in a petri dish or in a watch glass. And then add dilute iodine solution to it. You may take iodine solution in a small container and dip the leaves in those, or you can just pour a bit of iodine generously upon the leaves. These steps are common for any of the activities. It can be the activity with the variegated leaves in 6.1. So the green colored parts will show blue-black color. So when it is showing blue-black color, the inference. In the inference, you'll find different things, like say the leaf which is pale, alcohol which is now green, and third and final inference after I also had a test is blue-black color. Blue-black color of leaves. So this confirms that starch is present. Result? Starch is present. Understand? So these steps are common for any of the activities. When it comes to 6.2, you have taken two potted plants. With one of the potted plants, you have kept potassium hydroxide solution or potassium hydroxide flakes. In this case, I have used flakes. You may also keep solution. Potassium hydroxide has a property of absorbing carbon dioxide. Therefore, in one of the bell jars, the entire carbon dioxide is absorbed by potassium hydroxide. In the other bell jar, the CO2 is made available to the plant. So in which case there will be photosynthesis? Of course, the bell jar which is not having potassium hydroxide. Therefore, when you carry out all these steps properly, in the required sequence, the entire protocol is carried properly, you will be able to find the bell jar without potassium hydroxide is showing blue-black color of the leaves as a result. Whereas the other bell jar, which is having potassium hydroxide along with the plant, is not showing such kind of results. The leaves will remain pale. So this experiment proves that carbon dioxide is very essential for photosynthesis. In the same way, you may also prove the importance of water, the importance of sunlight. Plan about these activities. Think, because it's an open-ended question given to you in textbook. Thank you.